Hello, welcome back to another episode of Warframe. The previous episode actually has not been released yet, so I haven't read any comments or anything on it yet. But doing the sorties today, I got a Riven mod, which is one of the new mod types available in this game. It was released a couple patches ago. I talked about it at one point, but it's very brief, and I didn't have anything to show off really. For them. Though I have a few more now, it's not a whole lot, but yeah, this mod here, it's for the rifle. That's the name, Rifle Riven Mod. They can have 0 to 3 positive effects, or 0 to 1 negative effect, or 0 to 1 negative effect. So it can have up to 4 different effects on the mod itself, ranging in what it does. It's also specifically meant for a particular type of weapon, but for the purposes of unlocking it, it can be put on any rifle riven, or any rifle, any primary weapon. So, this one says to complete a solo interception mission with level 30 or higher enemies with a Hubble Dragon Key equipped without dying or becoming downed. So we are going to go as Nazav for that, and I have to get a Hobbled Key equipped. Let's go ahead and search. I do have one, so there we go. I am now hobbled, which means I am going to walk slow as balls. Thankfully, I'm Nizam. And I need to bring up a quick page about where all of the interception missions are. So we have to do solo. I'd prefer to go against the Grineer, so it looks like our only option for level 30 or higher is on Sedna. On a sector named Barahinia? Barahinia. This one. Okay, so this should be interesting. But yeah, Riven mods are very, very unique in that they are for only one weapon. They have up to three positive attributes to it and one negative attribute. Or up to one negative attribute. I don't know what DE was really intending with these mods, but they seem to be more geared towards weapons that aren't used too often. So I'm guessing that they added them to make some of the weapons that are not as worthwhile to be used, like the Jablok. It's an awesome weapon, but I can't see myself using it outside of just leveling it up. Or the Bratton. Even the Prime version of the Bratton seems kind of meh. So, yeah. I feel like the purpose of those mods are for those kind of weapons, and that definitely seems to be the case. There are some weapons that are rarely ever used by anyone, and it's because their damn stats and whatnot are so low, but the Rifle Riven mods, or the Riven mods in general, should help maybe to some extent with them. They are something I definitely need to play around with. This said, I don't know if there are better means to. Like. Overall. Just, like, make them better than a Riven mod ever could? I don't know this. But, the stats definitely do seem promising on some of these, so. I look forward to unlocking this one. And, seeing what's going on. Now, Riven mods in general have a stupid amount of different possibilities to unlock them. This is actually the first one I've had to deal with that has a solo mission on it. Other ones I've had to deal with are ones related to just killing a certain amount of enemies without being detected, stuff like that. Thankfully, we only hopefully have to do one round of this because I'm not the biggest fan of interception missions, let alone doing them alone. Especially with the Hobbled Key.
We have lost control of a tower.
Ah, good old them taking the point. Yeah, so the Hobbled Key modifies my movement speed for purposes of running and sprinting and stuff like that. But it does not modify my bullet jump or anything, so I'm able to use that to my advantage. The reason, by the way, I am using the Zaw is for the warding halo. If enemies like the Him try to get close to me, he will get knocked back just ever so slightly because of the halo causing burn damage around me. Wait, really? Really, guy? Get off the console. Yeah, so... I'm not against the hobbled key at all. I actually find the hobble key a little more interesting because it really does force you to exist on more of a bullet jumping plane rather than relying on sprinting and stuff like that. Her firewalker ability though would help me with running, but barely. Like it's a 30% increase or something like that. I actually don't recall the exact percentage boost on that. You can go away, Yakamaster. Oh, there's nobody around. Okay. Let's go ahead and do that. Get our energy regen going. Wait. Ah. Thought there was another guy somewhere. Oh, and they finally realized that D was not the best option to keep going after. What is our other goal? Oh, fourth ability once. Okay, well, that's been done. Naza's natural low friction helps as well with the hobbled key on getting around because I can just tap control. It'll allow me to slide at, I think, 40% reduced friction, and the hobbled key is not affected by that. So yeah, it's just trying to normally walk that really gets affected. Is that everybody? I think it is. Alrighty. So we should be able to get out of here when the dialogue picks up here. There we go. I'll take the Neo Relic. I got no problem with that. That was a Neo and 1 and 4. Yeah, I'll take that just fine. It's a good relic to have. So yeah, we should be able to see what the Riven mod is for now. Let's find out. What am I gonna roll into? Whatever the game decides to load.
Operator, messages have arrived in your inbox.
Okay. The Grokata Vexi Visitin. So this is for the Grokata, which is the primary version of the Twin Grokatas. I think we used the Twin Grokatas at one point in an episode, though I'm not 100% sure on that one. The Vexi Visitin, I don't know if that's just a randomly generated name or if it's based on the stats presented here, but what do we have here? 11.3% electricity, not bad. 6% magazine capacity, not bad. And 20.3% damage, ooh, nice. But reduction in status chance, I'm okay with this. This has a mastery rank requirement of 16, and this has up to 8 ranks to it that can be applied. And we got a mutagen mass for an evasion, that's what that mail is about. Let's see, do I even have the Grokata anymore? I do not. The reason I don't have it is because you require two of them for the twin Grokatas, which is the secondary. Alrighty. With that said, apparently our Javlock's at max rank, so we don't have to worry about that anymore. At least not for the time being, along with our Galantine. Let's get this hobbled key off.
It said cosmic background.
Ortis. Alright, so let's see, is there a new primary weapon that we have available? The Bratton Prime, I will take that. To level that up next for melee. We have the Aether Reaper, Aether Sword. Gazelle Machete sounds like fun. So I will take those. And yes, I did have to spend 12 plat to unlock 2 more weapon slots. And I did that without really caring too much. I have a decent amount of plat, 475 at the moment now. But I'll have to worry about it later down the road. But I want to be able to have like every single weapon available to me anyway. So I'm not too worried about it. So yeah, this here is the process of setting up one of the weapons for me to use. So this has a high slash, which I will gladly make use of. Need to get pressure point on here though. It's just pure damage boost, and buzz kill would be awesome. Do we have any other slash mods? We can go for that one. Or we could try to squeeze out a bit more of that. I think we throw that one on. That'll work for now, trying to max the slash damage on it, since I don't really have any other interest in that. And Serration for the Bratton. Here's a good example of what I'm talking about with the Bratton, by the way. Even the Prime version, 21 slash, 12.3 puncture, and 1.8 impact. It's not that high of a damage-based weapon. And this is a primed variant. Like, what? Why are those stats so low? As far as more, there is a Riven mod for the Bratton. So maybe that would help out in the long run, but I don't know. Next up, though, let's actually do a Kuva mission. Let's see, the Kuva Fortress is there, so it's on Mars, yep. A Kuva Siphon mission, specifically. Let's go for the rescue version. So the Kuva Siphon mission is the only way to get Kuva. And Kuva is used to re-roll the Riven mods, which we will take a brief look at after this mission. The re-roll will allow you to get different stats on it, so like say the Riven mod we just unlocked and we didn't like it. Well, we could roll it to try to get some better stats on it. I'm not gonna even try to walk through that. I forgot if it works or not with the warning halo. But if I tried walking through that and it affected me, it would remove all of my energy. These guys are actually not too shabby in level. They're what, 31? I think I saw one of them.
There's no telling what the captors are doing to our 29? Target. You need to find the holding cell.
29 to 31 probably. Oh, 27. 28. Okay, these guys are not as high level as I thought. I swear that one guy was level 31, though. Oh, we are near the Siphon.
Guardian, distract the child.
And that
the resonance frequency has changed.
Is one of the Guardians and the Queens I just talked to there. So yeah, I had showed that we could actually walk around as our operator. And this is the whole point of it. Oh, speaking of, where you at?
What a waste.
That little bit of Kuva thing there, that is what we are after. We gotta pick up four of those to destroy the raids around this Siphon device. It's a very interesting mechanic that they added to the game. Yeah, we just gotta wait around for the sound of the screams. And then we can go out and grab them by press control spacing to get to it. For those that played through the, the one mission. Crap, what was that mission called? Oh. Ow. Ah, hell, what? The War Within! The War Within is the name of it. There we go. Yeah, the War Within has the information about doing that because you actually have to fight these Kuva Guardians when you are dealing with the Queen. Now, I know I'm kind of making it look easy to do this, but trust me when I say the first time I had to deal with all these guys, it was not easy at all. There's a lot of problems going on with them. There we go. Got all four. That's destroyed. We got 636 Kuva for that. So now we can actually head into Enter the rescue bit of the mission. Shut up, Coop Queen. Nobody asked you.
You are approaching the Holman area. Careful. If the wardens detect you, they will surely initiate the execution sequence. Hurry up.
Damn it. Who the hell heard me? Oh, it was you.
The captive will be in one of these cells.
Wait.
Search them.
Cells down here. Let's just go ahead and use a couple ciphers to make this go by faster. Hello.
You've located the hostage. Escort the prisoner to the extraction point.
Well, all the wardens are dead. So we just got a bit of a bonus on the XP for that. Would have been more if we did it without getting caught.
Give me a weapon.
I'm not a fan of giving the hostage a weapon. Really? They locked me out? Actually, you guys can be spirit for a moment while I cipher that.
Override complete. Move on.
Alrighty. Let's get the hell out of here. Let's keep an eye on the hostage stats, though. Damn, enemies getting in the way with their hitbox. There we go. So that was a Koopa Siphon mission. There is also a Koopa Flood mission, which is very high level. It's like 80 to 100 or something like that. So that's really the only difference between a Koopa Siphon and a Koopa Flood mission. The Koopa Flood is just a naturally higher level. But yeah, we got Koopa. So let's actually head into the right table for once. Here's a mod table. Here are the 5 ribbon mods that I've collected out of a total capacity. Out of a total capacity of 15. So I really like the Gricata one. The Cernos, Concealed Lexicac, not the biggest fan of, so we can actually cycle it for 1200 Kuva. So, yeah, let's do it. So we got 10.5% fight speed, 10% toxin, and minus 6.5% crit chance. Otherwise, we can keep what we had initially, and in the bottom right, you can actually see I've re-rolled this 3 times now. That's what the little rotation symbol and the number by it means. Honestly, I'm going to keep that one. But yeah, now we can re-roll it again. I kind of wish there was a indicator of how much Kuva you actually have. We will try to cycle it once more, though. 3.7% damage to corpus, not bad. 15.2% damage, just straight-up damage. Multi-shot increase, and increased weapon recoil. I would love to get rid of the weapon recoil on that. That, by the way, is the negative modifier. They usually only show up on the bottom of the list, if there is one at all.
Operator, the system needs you.
I will confirm that one.
Mission.
So, how much Kuva do I have? There's the marker. 4,038. That's not too bad, actually. Is there anything else I would like to cycle? Yeah, the Hema Akritin. We can go ahead and cycle this mod. Hema Zeti Armor Tox. Reduced weapon recoil, so that's a positive. Increased magazine capacity and increased toxin, but reduced flight speed. I'm not sure I like this one any more than I like the other one. I really don't like either of them. I'll keep this one, though. Alright, and here is one that I had max ranked. It's 112.2% damage, 1.8 punch through, and 64.5% multi-shot on the Sybaris, which we do have. So let's see, Sybaris. We will go ahead and upgrade. Do I actually have the rifle mod on here? I do not. So this increases our status up to 15.9%, increases our damage up just a smidge, and it's taking up 18 mod points out of the 30 available, unless I was to put a, Is this a reactor? It's a potato. And then I could form it down the road to make it even better if I really wanted to, but yeah, so this is kind of the things to make some of the less used weapons better. Now, that 112.2% damage, I'm just going to search, and I know Serration is it. That's 165% damage, so this is actually better in terms of just straight-up damage increase, but the multi-shot on there helps a lot more. As you can see with the impact puncture and slash stats, it actually goes up higher. Now, if I was to have another mod on here that is just straight-up multi-shot, you can see the damage is only 43. So this is actually not a bad mod overall. It would actually work really well with split chamber and serration on it. And even heavy caliber. But it's very expensive. As you can see, it's actually the most expensive mod that I have available for the Sivirus. Heavy caliber is at max. So its max cost is 16. Most of the elemental mods are maxed at 11. The damage mods are at 14, punch through, stuff like that. So this mod here is the most expensive mod I have ever seen for a weapon in this game. Now, there is one that comes kind of close, and that is Blood Rush, but that's only 14. Even Primed Reach, which is a stupidly awesome mod for particular weapons, will only have a max cost of 14. So yeah, I don't know, it's a bit weird in that regards, but yeah, that is the Riven mods, kind of in a nutshell. I don't think there's anything else to really say about it. We might check out a Koopa Flood mission later on down the road, when I am not uploading and when one is available. It doesn't appear one's available just yet, so unless it's on a different planet? Oh, I kind of doubt that. Oh, wait, there is a Koopa Flood mission available. Mobile defense, huh? Koopa Siphon. You can see the Flood symbol differently because of the three rotating blood drips, whereas this one only has the one on the icon. But yeah, that's really about it for Koopa and Riven mods. They're very interesting, they're very unique, and I would be interested in getting more. I wonder if there's a way to increase mod capacity for them, if there's a way to have more than 15 of them. Riven mod slots. You can get 3 Riven mod slots for 60 plat. Okay. That's interesting. Maybe down the road I'll end up getting this, but for now, no. I only have 5 of the 15 to begin with, so. That'll be it for this episode, though. I hope you guys have enjoyed a little bit of Nazaar. And the Riven mod challenge, which honestly wasn't that much of a challenge for me. I just hate doing interception missions alone. It's really what it comes down to anyway. But yeah, until next time, as always, take it easy.